in the United States, children have the privilege of playing as well as being free. Sadly, that is not the case for children in Somalia. In the past few years, there have been a sudden increase in child abduction for recruitment.
I know is that when the Somali Civil War broke out in late 1990, I was 14 or 15, something like that. And I remember some malicious recruit young boys to fight on behalf of them. And maybe 15, 14, or even 16, 17, 18, early 20s, that kind of, that age group were the people who were fighting for the malicious, who overthrow the government, central government of Somalia. And it's even today, some militias use young boys to fight for them, as young as 14, 15, but then I think mostly older, maybe, but then the youngest around that age, that's my thinking. Or what I read or observed from the news, that kind of age group or older, 13 or older, or even 15 or older. So I know there is in the world, and particularly in conflict zones in the world, young boys are used or recruit to fight for the hungry power leaders. I think recruiting boys or even girls sometimes to fight on behalf of adults is really bad thing, bad idea. They could be used in different things. They could be educated and could be doctors, lawyers, engineers, and human rights activists, entrepreneurs, instead of being killing machine for some power hungry bosses or leaders. So for me, it's really bad thing to use these innocent boys and girls to be a child soldier.
The exact number of child soldiers is unknown. Estimation of 2,000 to 3,000 children in different armed groups. The Somali National Army had 223 children within their ranks by the end of 2013. The monitoring of rape and other forms of sexual violence against children remain a challenge. A total of 1,870 violations against children were documented.